Hey guys, it's Steve, and after a lot of time, after waiting of a lot of time, I have done just a few days back, I have done just previews and first look also of Wolverine Swan. Here we go with the original series, first issue, that is really good, but it didn't get that much of a rating from the reviewers because it's quite a bit of unexpected things did just happen on this one. IGN is really unhappy with this one. There's a lot to be said for the weekly format. When it's executed properly, Marvel could just as easily have launched new solo titles for Deacon, Sabretooth, X-23 et al. With different creative teams and left it at that. But a weekly series helmed by Charles Soule and Ray Fox means that the overarching story will remain focused and purposeful even as individual arcs move in their own directions. Frankly, the larger X-Men franchise could benefit from a similar treatment. So the general premise of this series is sound. Unfortunately, it doesn't come together all that well in issue 1. More than anything, the problem stems from Soule's efforts to juggle too many characters at once. This isn't a particularly clean start for the new series. Wolverine is already building directly from both Death of Wolverine, The Logan Legacy, and Death of Wolverine, The Weapon X Project. This issue includes the full costs from both by the time Soule is thorough through introducing the entire gang and setting up their first big fight scene, there's little room for anything else compared to it. To a similar project like Batman Eternal, that series started small and built towards larger conflicts. It didn't throw Red Robin, Bluebird, Selina Kyle, Spoiler, and the rest of Batman's allies at readers in the first issue. Hopefully, once the Wolverine's cast is broken up a bit and subsequent arcs focus on specific characters, the series as a whole will improve. It remains to be seen if the character's dynamics can keep readers coming back as well. Soule showed a strong, very minimalist take on writing Wolverine in the original Death of Wolverine miniseries. Unfortunately, that death hasn't been as apparent in this Fallout project. There's an excess of dialogue in this issue as characters are prone to stating their feelings, rehashing old relationships, and generally providing an unnecessary level of exposition. But sometimes it feels more like low-budget movies also. But overall, this is not just up to the mark. That's why, because it may happen, we had a lot of expectation from Wolverine Swan because it's a really a huge brand. That's why the good things about this one, who would have thought the death of Wolverine could lead to so much. Okay, let me tell you before that, this is a review given by Tony Jim and Guerrero, and this is comicfine.com. could lead to so much. Following Wolverine's death, we had a couple of series that Death of Wolverine, The Logan Legacy, and Death of Wolverine, The Weapon X program carry on the story and introduced us to some new characters. I'm a fan of Nick Bradshaw's art, and FCO plus any does an amazing job on the colors. Unfortunately, there's a but coming. The bad things about this one, as much as I enjoy Bradshaw's art, it doesn't feel like it sets the right tone for this series. Combined with Plasenius CS colors, the book looks too bright and cheerful. We have a book full of deadly killers in search of a dead body. Even seeing Mystique covered in blood or Sabretooth get smacked by an enchanted wrecking ball doesn't look as bad as it should. For readers that haven't read both that Death of Wolverine minis, they might be a little lost. It might be a hard sell for them to jump into a weekly book priced at $3.99, where the half of the characters might be unknown to them. We also have a strange two-page shift in art as Alison Borges fills in. The art is nice, but it feels like an interruption by being a noticeable change. That's changed sometimes, but hope you guys will like it. The verdict about this one, Marvel's first weekly title is off to a good start. I don't know what's gonna happen on the next issues, that means issue number 2, but all the best to Marvel, and hope you guys will like it. Don't forget to leave a like and buy the book to create the supporters.